Hello everyone, I welcome you all to today's session. Today I will start class 3 EVS chapter 2. The name of the chapter is The Way the Earth Looks. As we all know that our earth is very vast, it is very big in size. Thus, it is not possible for us to see the entire earth at a time. Does anybody can tell me then how do we study the earth? Yes, it is with the help of a globe. A globe is a model of the whole earth. You can see the entire earth on the globe. As you can see on the screen, it rotates on the metal rod which looks like an axis of the earth. Like I just said, you can see the entire earth on the globe, but it is not possible to show all the places on the globe. Only a very big globe can show all the places. But again, it will be very difficult to carry that globe around. Thus, the geographers came up with a solution, and the solution was map. They started using map to study a places. Now let us see what is a map. A map is a drawing of a whole or a part of the earth on the flat surface. There are many types of maps, but in your book you will study about two. That is world map and the wall map. Now let us see what are they. A wall map is the one which you can put on the wall, and world map is the one which shows the entire surface of the earth. I think I'm clear till here. So now let's move to the next topic, that is atlas. Atlas is also used to study about the places. It is a book or a collection of maps where you will find a detailed study of a place. On the earth, yes, if you have noticed, you will see either water bodies or the land masses. So what are they? The very large area of the land that you find on the earth are continents. There are total 7 continents on the earth. They are North America, South America, Europe, Asia, Africa, Australia and Antarctica. Now let us see about the largest and the smallest continent. Out of all the 7 continents, Asia is the largest continent, and India is a country which is located in the continent Asia. And Australia is the smallest continent. Now let us see about the oceans. Oceans are a very large area of the water that is found on the earth. There are 5 main oceans. Now what are they? Let us see. They are Arctic Ocean, Atlantic Ocean, Pacific Ocean, Indian Ocean and Southern Ocean. In your book, you will find only 4 students, so don't get confused. Pacific Ocean is the largest ocean and Arctic Ocean is the smallest one. Now let us read about reading of the map and direction. A map tells us about the location of different places. So we can find the location of different places on the map with the help of the direction. Now there are 4 main directions. They are north, south, west and east. Remember students, whenever a map is hung on the wall or is kept on the table, the topmost portion always shows the north and the bottom portion shows south. East is in your right side and west is in your left. Now let us see about the symbols. There are some symbols that are used on the map to make the reading of the map easy. Now what are they? For example, a blue color on the map is used to show the water bodies, and the brown color is used to show the land. There are many other symbols too. Now, last topic is compass. The compass, as you can see on your screen, there is a diagram of a compass. It is an instrument which is used to locate a place. Now, the needle that you can see, the needle always point on the north side. The compass are mainly used by the sailors to find out in which direction they should sail. So, that's all for today. I hope you have liked the session.